Hi, this is DMC's Tony Pritz. The art of turntablism has evolved in just 2 decades. It all began when Grand Wizard Theodore created a scratch effect, furthered by legends such as Grandmaster Flash, Grand Mixer DST, until people like Cash Money, Jazzy Jeff, and the second generation DJs took the art to a new plane. Since 1985, DMC has hosted the world's greatest battles, thanks to the support of Technics and their robust SL1200 turntable, without which there would never have been an art in the first place. Here you see gathered a handful of human beings who carry the title DMC World Champion. The list began with DJ Cheese, Chad Jackson, Cash Money, Cutmaster Swift, DJ David, the Rocksteady DJs and the Dream Team, who later became known as the Invisible Scratch Pickles, featuring Qbert, Mixmaster Mike, and Shortcut. Then came Rock Raider, Denmark's Noise, Canada's A-Track, and, to date, the serial killer himself, Miami's DJ Craze. To attain their standards, to become a world champion, will need dedication, application, and a real tunnel vision. The know-how is much easier than the reality. So let's start with the knowledge. Right here, right now, it's time.
Hi, we're here with DJ Go from the UK crew, the Mixologist, who's going to demonstrate a couple scratches and basically setting up and finding your sounds. So, what's the procedure, Go?
Well, first of all, you've got to tighten that hole.
And why are we doing that?
Because with the bigger, bulkier cartridges and stuff, it tends to jump and stuff with the movement here.
So we're basically filling the hole so the record doesn't wobble a lot, which can cause feedback and the record jumping and stuff like that. So you spend quite a lot of time in preparing all your records then for before you start DJing.
You don't waste time with it jumping and stuff. Yeah, that's kind of all right.
Okay. So now that we've marked that up, what's the next procedure? What are we doing now?
Well, now like mark it up like a clock. So we need just a visual sticker.
Right. So if we now zoom in on the label here, if you imagine that this is 12 o'clock, 3, 6, 9, Go's now gonna put a label on the record so he'll be able to cue his sounds. So you're now finding your sound. What kind of sounds do you look for when you're scratching, when you start working on scratches?
Well, I like long sounds because basically you can do everything. You can mess about with the start bit of the sound.
Yeah.
Or you can, you know, use the whole sound.
So for someone who's just getting into scratching, it's best for them to use very long sounds. So
yeah, either a tone or like an R or a
scream.
Like that, yeah.
Go with it there.
I want that sound right there. So I remember where it is. Hold it and then put the sticker on.
So from our angle, this is 12 o'clock. From yours, this is 6 o'clock. Yeah?
See, the sound kind of starts right at 12.
Yep, it's cued. He's put the tape right on where the sound starts at midday.
Wow,
or
I'm
six,
ready
sorry.
To go. It doesn't jump.
So we're just checking now that the vinyl doesn't jump too much.
Yeah, you've got to wear it in a bit as well.
Yeah. Because this is brand new vinyl, so later on it'll look like this. Fingerprinted and everything else. That's when the vinyl's a bit more wear and the grooves are more
stable.
Stable, yeah. Right. So what you're doing now when you're rubbing, just explain what you're doing when you're actually rubbing so we hear that continuous sound. Right. You notice he's moving the record backwards and forwards and he's got the fader open. So it's basically a mix between the two, what you're actually doing when you're cutting and you're rubbing. And most importantly, again, he's actually making a rhythm just from what you're hearing here. You can hear a rhythm there.
are tears.
These actually tears, but just the way you move the record.
Right, a tear, just to break that down and explain what...
A tear is, instead of bringing the record back in one straight motion, you kind of divide it in two, so it cuts the sound.
Okay. So every time you're bringing it back, you're kind of stopping and then you're starting again. So just slow that right down. Just slow that right down. So you're basically going from there, stop, and there.
There's a lot. Combine tears with a kraz.
Quite nice just to have a beat first, and if you can't get into it, then just switch the beat off and listen to the cut on its own.
So, I mean,
you can hear it for what it is.
A lot of people can put the record on and they're just, for example, if I just show. So, I've got the record on and I'm playing it and I'm just learning to scratch. So I'm scratching. But am I really scratching?
Scratching your ass there.
What's the first scratch you can remember learning?
First scratch.
Okay, now that was your first scratch you learned, but there was quite a lot of different techniques in there. Can you just explain what you did and how you actually mastered doing those techniques as well? Because although that may seem very simple, because Go is a professional, trained professional, executing these things, you know, for a first time, someone who's just getting into this, there's a lot of coordination going on there. So let's break that down and slow it right down and let's see what are you actually doing.
So like, first thing is just watch the sticker.
So you're watching that sticker now to see where that sound's starting from, and he's always cueing it back to that point, which is 6, where you are actually looking.
Well, I can start like 1 o'clock.
Now you're moving this fader here on the mixer. Just explain what you're doing, moving, why you are moving that back up and down like that.
The fader's like an on and off switch, especially the crossfader. It's like, when it's off, you get no sound coming out, so you don't get that back scraping sound.
If you left that fader up, you'll get what sound? That's the sound you're getting when you leave the fader up. So like I said, he's coordinating between the fader and moving the vinyl backwards and forwards. So every time he moves the vinyl back, he's basically bringing the fader down so we don't hear that back rub. So that's cutting.
Well, I know a master of the basics, my friend Yo, from Mixologist, he's going to show you how to do the basic scratches.
Okay. Right, Yo, just give us an example of what what you can do, and then we'll break that down.
Okay.
Yeah.
I show my chops.
Chops. Okay.
Yep.
Which is what Go was doing earlier, and this is chops when they're chops.
Yeah.
Right. So. Just hold the chop part of that.
Yeah.
Because actually he was releasing it, so you heard the fresh come out as well. So just hold the chop. That's the chop there. That's the chop. Yeah, the fader and the vinyl in sync. Right, that's also known as the chirp. Let's break that down exactly what's part of the vinyl you're actually cutting when you're doing that. Can you slow that right down?
Okay.
So we're hearing the front of the sound, and we're hearing the reverse of the sound. Yeah? So he was splitting the front part and cutting the fader and bringing it back and cutting the fader. If we break it right down, if I can just demonstrate this. So you heard this? This is the chirp, and then that's the sound. Yeah, that's how he was breaking it down. So here we go. So do you want to put that over some music now?
Okay.
Let's just do a little demonstration of that. There's the chirps. Chops. feel too frustrated if you can't get it straight away, because obviously Yo is a trained professional again. He's obviously mastered this. How long did it kind of take you to get these techniques?
I started DJ 3 years ago.
3 years,
and,
right?
First year, I do, you know, kind of basic scratch, like chop, back scratch.
Yeah.
So I can say one year.
1 year.
1 year to get
fast.
Musical.
Mm. Yeah. Okay. So again, you know, a lot of DJs spend a lot of hours and time, you know, and it is something that you will develop over time. I mean, mastering the chirp at first, it is a pretty much patting your stomach and rubbing your head at first. There was a lot of syncopation between the vinyl and, you know, this crossfader. Again, there's lots of different positions where you might want to place your hand. You know, some people place theirs down there. Yo had these here. Pioneers like Cash Money hold the side of the vinyl. So don't feel that you have to actually adapt a style that you may see someone doing. Get comfortable with the vinyl, and you know, it's really a case of working on syncopation between the two, excuse me. Supposedly it was invented by a DJ called Spinbad from Philadelphia.
That's it.
Yeah. So let's find this. What kind of sounds are right for transforming? Because certain scratches sound more dynamic with certain sounds, don't they?
Yeah, for transforming, because you're cutting the sound in and out quite a lot of stuff. It's normally long sounds which you can practice a lot better on, but once you sort of progress and you've got it down, it's like small sounds you can transform quicker and that. So
yeah.
To start with, like long sounds and that. So. Oh, it's perfect.
There's our R sound again.
Obviously, so we're transforming. It's just like with the fader off.
Yeah.
You let the sound play, and then you click the fader in and out for like, that's one click.
Yeah.
So up, closed, open, shut.
Yeah.
And that, and if you repeat that, it carries on.
So you did about three clicks there, and that's how we hear the R.
Yeah, you're just chopping the sound into little segments, basically.
Yeah.
So you get like a almost time stretched sound. So it's like.
So just play that sound once again in its original form. Have you noticed what he's doing? He's just opening and shutting the fader, and he's chopping that sound.
And once you sort of master that, you can do it forwards and then sort of backwards as well.
Yeah.
So it's like.
So now you're not just chopping the front, you're actually chopping the back as well. So. What about the rhythmic side of it now? How does that work?
Once you get sort of more fluid with like the forward and the back, you can make it maybe go faster.
Yeah.
And so you could do like a faster forward one, maybe a slower back one, or other way around, using sort of the record hand to sort of make the record sort of faster or slower and that.
How much pressure are you applying to the vinyl to actually bring it back? Because, I mean, for a new DJ, he's got to get familiar with actually applying pressure to the vinyl. I mean, do you apply just enough so the vinyl's still moving quite smoothly?
I think it depends on that, what you're doing that, because if you put too much pressure on it and stuff, the sound might become sloppy and that. So I'm quite light fingered in that, so if I put too much pressure on the back pull, it might sound a bit like too stiff and that, and you can't get the fluid sort of da.
So I understand that.
Kind of just quite light sort of, kind of.
Okay.
Nimble fingered.
So let's demonstrate some of the more of the pattern size side to it. And okay.
So you, one of the turntablists, Benny G, mixologist, practice hard.
Yo, check it out. This is the Apollo, aka PLO Style, and you're watching what's that?
The Art of Turntablism. Yes.
Fantastic.
Okay, here we are in the capital of hip hop, New York City. Cutmaster Swift's here to go into the greatest hip-hop record shop in town. Talking about Fat Beats. And you got some friends waiting in there, Johnny, yeah?
I believe so, Tony.
Let's go in and meet them. Yeah, come on.
J
Okay, here we are, everybody. This is it. This is it, Johnny. We've landed. This is the greatest hip hop shop in the world.
Just full of records.
Everybody, it's always packed. Always packed. You can't get in before 12 o'clock because it's a late starting store. Go and have a look around, Johnny. See if there's anybody you recognise in here.
I think they're all over here. Is Mr. Oh, yeah. Thing, the current DMC champion, first rate?
Hello.
Beatboxing Keller. Give us a quick sound.
Sounds good.
Runner-up champion, Tony Vegas. I get you doing a little session on this thing.
Let's move around. Sparky T from Greece.
Say hello to the camera, don't be shy.
Hello.
Rolling, keep
rolling. Hi, Rocky from Holland. Do you see Wex Wenger's baby?
Hello,
legendary champion DJ Noise, can't resist the record selection. What have you got there, sir?
Just like repressions for old stuff, like a Steezo, 12
yep.
inches, yep. 2 of each, you gotta have 2 of each.
Yeah, of course, 2 and copies essential. Legendary Babu from the Beat Junkies.
So Swift?
Yeah, man. What's going on?
Hanging out, buying some records.
Buying some records.
Yeah.
No doubt we'll see. Get some comments from Babu about scratches, techniques, and you know, opinions, and probably tell us what half of these stars actually are, because I can't keep up with these names. So. There's two particular ways you can have the crossfader. There's the normal way, which is left to right. So right is right deck, left is left deck. Or you can have it the hamster style, which is basically the fader in reverse. So this side will be right, that side will be left. Hope I'm quite clear with that. And also the faders are reversed as well on this mixer. So because Tony, you does most of his stuff in hamster style. If you'd like to...
Because I'm backwards.
compatible. Year 2000 and all that. You do the magic. We're just going to have a little groove over this.
Yeah.
All right, he's going to do a little groove over this and then we'll just go through some of the patterns that he actually has done. Round of applause. Woo! Woo! okay.
Alcoholics.
Just explain a bit about some of the stars you just did there, Tony, and
simple stuff really.
Simple stuff, he says.
No, just open up baby scratcher. Just using the ups, single click flares on
okay,
the ups.
Okay, let's just go over them in a more slower form and you know.
That's okay.
At this time, you need a good pause button and a decent VCR, so you should be able to slow down and hopefully
start off.
So this is the rub, this is the basic element of scratching, invented by Grand Wizard Theodore, putting it into a rhythmic form. So that's the rub.
Scratch. I think that's my favourite scratch of all time. A few echoes at the beginning as well.
Let's just slow down how you're actually doing those echoes. If you noticed, if you want to explain it, Tony, I'll shut up a bit.
Just taking the up fader down, just the volume control on the mixer really, in coordination with your hand on the record. You're just letting the record go, releasing the fader, but gradually taking the up fader down as you go through.
Yeah.
A little bit faster.
You should now just hear that echoing. So let's just go into the various styles of rubs you was actually doing in there. Okay.
I did some single clicks on the ups.
And those you can also echo basically out.
You can echo those.
I also noticed you was actually getting a click flare without even having your hand on the vinyl. Can you just explain how you was actually achieving that?
Same theory. You know, the hands can be an extension of a fader, they can work exactly the same way.
Mm-hmm.
In stopping a record, you can achieve the same sound difference that a crossfader would give you. So just doing, you break the sound down the same way that a fader does. With two hands.
You'd be a good baker, you know, Tom. Basically, the functions of the fader is to cut the sounds out, yeah, basically, you know. And as they are faders, they do that, they fade. And you basically, what he's actually doing with the vinyl, with his hand, he's actually stopping the vinyl and letting it go, simulating the fader.
Other things with throwing rubs again.
Yep, some of them rubs. Again, if he was to slow this down, he's basically stopping the vinyl in millionths of a second. Millionths of a second.
Trying to do that as slow as possible.
You can hear that growling sound there.
Yep,
and what about some of those faded techniques? Just give us an idea how you kind of came out with those ideas and what you was actually doing.
Clearly the way I look at everything is because I use the mix of reverse for juggling, scratching. Gives me the advantage of being able to have little finger on the record, thumb therefore reaches this up fader which controls that side. So I can just go like thumb.
Because you notice he's actually cutting out the left turntable there, as well as manipulating the right one in time to go.
There's so many things that I can do with that.
Obviously, doing that, it must make it a bit strenuous on your little finger.
Yeah.
Any exercise tips or anything?
Just look at those great hands. no, People have all these weird kind of things and hook themselves up to power supplies in the wall to shake, and it's like...
I can't say this is kids'
program video. Yeah, but basically I kind of get away with it just by giving my girlfriend a really good finger in it.
This is the adult version, by the way.
You know that's going in the video. Yeah.
Yeah, you know I'm going out the front door when I go home anyway, so I've really got nothing to lose anymore. No, I don't know. People just find, however people find themselves comfortable. A lot of people use those hand grip things, and you know, others don't. I never have done. You know, when I started, the only exercise was just nose, and that was all it was.
And this is the actual style that you've actually called the Vegas.
No, the Vegas was. Yeah. I'll see if I can do. I haven't done this thing in a while. I haven't done it in a while. The Vegas was basically that. Okay. Kind of helps if you have that kind of loud so you can hear it. Let's try that again. Just a simple thing like that, which is you end up kind of drilling that side and just transforming that side.
Yeah.
Just with both of those. It's just an idea that I had a long, long while ago, and did that with it, and then realised that there's quite actually nothing else you can do with it, so it's pointless. But it looks good.
It looks good.
I mean, that looks great. That not sounds so good. Sort of girls like it. Yeah, it's just, you know, I just simply because I use everything reverse. You know, a lot of guys use a mix of reverse just for scratching, and with a hamster switch, just switch it back to normal for juggling.
Yeah.
Everything I've ever done has been reverse.
Is it something you just took to straight away, or is it something you had to kind of train yourself?
6 years ago, I started normal.